Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. Comet science may stand at the precipice of revolutionary change. For well over half a century, consensus scientific theory has proposed that comets are icy bodies that formed billions of years ago in the solar system's infancy. Comet activity, including the production of filamentary jets and a cometary coma, is said to result from the sublimation of ices as a comet's orbit brings it closer to the Sun. However, for many years, scientific discovery has done nothing to increase confidence in standard comet theory. Close-up images of comet nuclei have revealed desiccated terrains, with nothing like the expected abundance of surface ice, and the hypothesized subsurface comet ice remains conjecture. Scientists have never found the theoretical vents or nozzles from which comet jets are thought to emanate, just one of many puzzles that demand new pathways of investigation. Electrical theories of comets may provide such pathways. Many of the most surprising comet discoveries were either predicted or become explicable by electrical interpretations, including the discovery of fast-moving electrons and electric fields close to the nucleus of Comet 67P. The detection of the signature of water molecules in cometary comas has long been thought to confirm the existence of abundant subsurface comet ice. But is there a better explanation? For several years, Thunderbolt's colleague Dr. Franklin Anariba has developed concepts of electrochemical reactions on comets, which may be the cause of much comet activity, including the production of the detected comet water. Recently, scientists studying data on the Lovejoy comet C2014Q2 have reported findings that may affirm many of the principles Dr. Anariba has proposed. Today, Dr. Anariba offers a detailed analysis of these findings and explains the electrochemical processes that may happen on comets.
Let us put things in perspective. After the completion of the Rosetta probe journey around the comet 67P, the origin of water observed in the coma is not clear, especially since the surface of the comet has been determined to be dark and dry. However, there are other possibilities for the origin of such water. Let us discuss one possibility. In a recent paper by Pagini et al. Titled "Ground-based detection of deuterated water in comet C/2014Q2, also known as Lovejoy, at infrared wavelengths," published in the Astrophysical Journal of Letters, comet Lovejoy is studied via infrared spectroscopy at an Earth-based observatory using infrared emission lines for water, H2O, and heavy water, HDO, where D refers to deuterium, which contains one proton, two neutrons, one electron, unlike hydrogen, which contains one of each. The study used a near-infrared spectrometer located at the Keck Observatory during post-perihelion. The results suggest a water production rate of 5.9 times 10 to the 29 molecules per second, or about 17,641,196 liters per second, and a heavy water production rate of 3.6 times 10 to the 26 molecules per second, or about 11,255 liters per second. From these production rates, the DH ratio in comet Lovejoy's water is extracted to be 3.02 times 10 to the minus 4, or more meaningfully, about 1.94 versus the DNI standard mean ocean DH ratio, which is taken as the benchmark and refers to the DH ratio in the ocean on Earth. It is important to highlight in this report that the DH ratio was methodically obtained by avoiding unnecessary systematic variables, such as measurements on different days, different telescopes, as well as observations of water and heavy water separately. Subsequently, this DH ratio is compared against measurements carried out pre-perihelion via radio wave means, which display a ratio of only 0.89 versus the DNI standard mean ocean water. In other words, the DH ratio increases by a factor of 2.2, pre to post perihelion. This is of significance. In the manuscript titled 67P, Shremov-Gerasimenko, a Jupiter family comet with high pH ratio by Outlaw et al. Published in Science. A pH ratio value of 5.3 times 10 to the minus 4 is reported, which is not consistent with previous Jupiter family of comets, JFC data, strongly suggesting that the pH ratio of the Jupiter family of comets is highly heterogeneous. The cause of this high pH ratio is usually attributed to deuterium-enriched water ice in the protosolar nebula. Since this solar system formation is speculative, I will not elaborate on such explanation. However, a recent article by Yao and Yapis titled Dynamic Deuterium Enrichment in Cometary Water via Elly-Rydell Reactions, a different pathway for deuterium enrichment is proposed, namely the collision of cold with 10 to 15 electron volts and hyperthermal with 10 to 200 electron volts water ions against deuterium-enriched surfaces. The authors state water ions in the extended coma are accelerated toward the nucleus, where they collide with the outer nucleus crust of 67P, where the crust is dehydrated and includes typical cometary minerals such as olivine and pyroxene silicates and carbonaceous refractory minerals. Likewise, cold water ions moving away from the nucleus will collide with those particles in the extended coma, which have a chemical composition similar to that of the nucleus crust. The authors were able to demonstrate in the laboratory that silicon oxide and highly ordered graphite carbon absorb deuterium atoms via the bombardment of heavy water ions, D2O+, for 30 minutes at 200 electron volts, resulting in the formation of H2DO+ cations. This chemical pathway proposed can reasonably be called water ion implantation on the surface of the nucleus, and it is based on observational facts, especially the reported presence of hyperthermal water ions in the vicinity of Comet 67P, although less certain on the nature of deuterated surfaces on comets. The key concept is that electric fields lead the way for the chemical reaction. I did previously state that a great number of chemical compounds observed in the coma and surface of comets is being driven electrochemically by energy provided to electric fields, which accelerate ions to sufficient kinetic energies and collision angles to result in bond formation processes. Therefore, it is quite refreshing to see that other researchers are beginning to be comfortable with the idea that a great number of complex chemical reactions are being driven by electrochemical means in the absence of solar radiation and or high temperatures. Provided the data reported for Comet Lovejoy indicating an increase in the pH ratio pre and post-perihelion is subsequently validated, I would argue that such data is an indirect indication of the influence of the solar flux in the electrochemical formation of water and heavy water observed in the coma and nucleus of comets. It is well known that deuterium is synthesized in the atmospheres of stars, and this applies to the sun, which then ejects deuterium via the solar flux electric fields. As a comet approaches the sun to an increasing voltage gradient, it encounters a higher deuterium density, which translates to an increased electrochemical heavy water formation, providing an overall high pH ratio as a function of heliocentric distance. In summary, in this episode, I propose that heavy water formation is not necessarily the result, although it can be to some extent, of water implantation on deuterated surfaces, but rather a direct electrochemical process mediated by electric fields of concentrated deuterium containing the solar flux interacting with hydroxide ions originating from refractory minerals and carbonaceous materials found in dust grains in the coma, as well as on the surface of comets. The complex chemical reactions observed on comets and other cosmic bodies are very likely driven by electrochemical means at low temperatures and in the absence of solar radiation.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.